The candidates for Wisconsin's open U.S. Senate seat, Democrat Tammy Baldwin and Republican Tommy Thompson, squared off in their first debate Friday night in Milwaukee. They'll meet in two more debates, including one that I'll be moderating on October 26th at Marquette University Law School. You can see it on this upfront station. Tammy Baldwin is giving up her seat in Congress to run for the U.S. Senate. The two candidates seeking to replace her are Democratic State Representative Mark Pocan and Republican businessman Chad Lee of Mount Horeb. We talked to Chad Lee last week on Upfront. Today we're joined by the Democrat, Mark Pocan. It's good to have you back on the program.
Yeah, Thanks very much, Mike.
Let's talk about how you would be different than Tammy Baldwin. Should voters of that district expect there would be any significant difference?
Well, I think you're going to find I have very similar values to Tammy Baldwin. So politically, you're going to find someone who has the same approach at our value system and ideology. I think the bigger difference might be in how I'd run the office. You know, in the legislature, I was there for 14 years. I served on the Joint Finance Committee, had to work with both parties to get things done, got a lot of things done while I was there. And I think that, you know, I look at Dave Obey and how he ran his office and what he was able to do for Wisconsin. I would really like to, you know, take in some of the best of various people I've seen. And I think it, you'll see very similar values to Tammy Baldwin, but really looking at how we can help not only pass things in Washington in a bipartisan way, but bring things back to Wisconsin to help businesses and people here.
We had Chad Lee on this program a week ago, and I asked him about you, and he said, you know, Representative Pocan is not the solution. He's part of the problem. He said, look at his voting record at the state capitol. He and his party helped create a budget nightmare for the state. And this is not a guy who's going to solve the problems out in Washington. What's your response?
Yeah, well, Chad probably doesn't realize what happened was we, as 49 states did, inherited these big deficits because of the federal economy. But when Democrats were in control and I was co-chair of the Finance Committee, we solved a $6.6 billion deficit. We cut about $2.5 billion, we raised some revenue, and we had some recovery dollars. So I've actually been there when we've had to make tough decisions and tough cuts, but also when we've had to raise some revenue. Revenue that when the Republicans took over this session, almost every single dollar revenue they kept that we put in place the session before. So I've had to make the tough decisions, and I've been able to do them in a bipartisan way, and I think I can bring that to Congress.
I want to talk to you about that bipartisan nature of your work. You just touted that. I read your announcement when you became a candidate in this race, and you talked about the difference between compromise and capitulation. Mm-hmm. Now, we've got big problems in this country. We've got a huge debt problem. It seems like people are going to have to compromise, but you know, when I hear you say that, I'm wondering, are you willing to do that?
Yeah, well, absolutely. I mean, part of it is you have to have your core values, and we're always going to have your core values that you're going to fight for, things like, you know, the preservation of Medicare and Social Security, issues like that. But at the same time, we ultimately have to get something done. I mean, that's the only thing we are elected to do is get something done. We're facing what they call the fiscal cliff at the end of the year. It's going to get punted into the next Congress. So probably one of the first things I'm going to have to deal with is really resolving that issue. But I think the way I've done it in the legislature for 14 years is the way I'll try to do it in Congress. You have to have win-win on both sides to actually have a compromise that works, that people can go back and be able to hang their hat on something. But we have to get something done. And this current Congress has been completely dysfunctional, extending things for 2 or 3 months at a time. That's not Democratic dysfunction. That's not Republican dysfunction. That's just dysfunction. And hopefully, based on the experiences I've had in the legislature, I can find ways to try to rise above that and get us to work together and get some things done.
What's the big issue in this race? Is it Medicare? Democrats are pushing that issue very hard, but yet, and maybe not as much for your district, but the economy still remains top of mind for most people. What's the big issue?
Yeah, I think, you know, both of those issues are really what you're hearing a lot when we go out and talk to folks. One, you know, we have to continue to keep the economy rolling. It is coming back. It's coming back a little slower than we'd like. But we need to make sure that we're still helping small businesses so they can grow the economy, so that we're still addressing where there's infrastructure needs, and we need to participate in that. But Medicare is a huge issue. When you have the Romney-Ryan budget that's out there that's supported by Tommy Thompson and others, the real problem is they want to fix Medicare. Well, anyone who has a dog knows what that means, right? Things are never quite the same afterwards, and you go through a lot of pain on the process. I don't think we need to fix Medicare. What we need to do is make sure that Medicare preserves what it does, but then also maybe looks at doing some things like allowing us to negotiate for prescription drugs with companies a little more effectively. There's things we can do to make it a better program, but the fix that the Republicans are proposing really is a pretty serious cut, and it's going to be coupons you're going to have in the future. You don't get health care through coupons. We have to make sure that we preserve a program like that.
And you can do that. You can come up with the money to do that. I mean, is the money there?
Yeah, I think part of the thing we need to look at is the Bush tax cuts for the wealthiest can't continue because that's a lot of money that's going out of the economy that's not coming back in. They told us it was going to create jobs. It didn't. We renewed it. It still didn't. It's time to stop that and get some of that money back. But secondly, we might have to look at maybe raising the cap on Medicare so that people who make more are paying, still paying. It's one of the few taxes we have that's not progressive. It actually stops, and if you're wealthy, you pay less than people who aren't so wealthy. So I think there's ways we can make sure that it's preserved, but let's also look at strengthening it. But, you know, this idea of vouchers and coupons, this, you know, Republican Romney, Ryan, Thompson idea is just not going to be good for the middle class.
Democratic State Representative Mark Pocan, the Democratic candidate in the 2nd Congressional District. We appreciate your time. Thanks very much for being with us.
Thank you.
Next, lawmakers try again for a mining bill. Is there more optimism now for agreement? But first, our look at the WisPolitics week ahead, and President Obama and Mitt Romney meet for their first debate of the fall, a discussion of domestic policy. That's Wednesday night in Denver.